Hi, AT from CNC at Home. In a previous video, we took an image and converted it into a vector drawing by doing a trace image. And we did that so that we could use the cut shape option to cut this into multiple sections. The intent was to show how we could deal with an image that's larger than our cut area. In this particular case, I believe we made the height of this 600 millimeters, which obviously makes that bigger than our cut area. Then by putting a series of squares on here that represented our tiles, we then used the cut shapes, which we find under tools, to break this into multiple images. That allowed us then to just burn a number of tiles that would fit in our cutting area. That works great if you can convert your image into a vector like we did here. What do you do when you can't do that? In this video, I want to use LightBurn to show another method how you do this similar process, but to an actual image versus a vector or line drawing. Let's take a look at that. Before we get too far in this video, please give this video a thumbs up and think about subscribing. Let's start with an image. I'll pull an image into the drawing. For those of you that have been on the channel for a while, you've heard of Buck Frenzy. It's a fun camping trip that my son and I have done for several years. If we wanted to burn the Buck Frenzy logo onto multiple tiles, and again, let's make this bigger. We'll make the width, 600. So it's definitely bigger than our burn area. We can't use the cut shapes because this isn't a shape, it's an image. We can do a process that's somewhat similar, and let me show you how that works. We start out kind of the same way. I'm going to create a square, and I'm going to do 109 millimeters because that's the size or approximate size of a tile, and I'm going to put it down here in my lower left hand corner. Then I'm going to grid this out so that I have an idea of how many tiles this is going to take. So it looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, let's go with 6. Yep. And then vertically, looks like we can get away with 4 vertically. We'll click OK on that. All right, that looks like that will work pretty well. Now the difference with this method is we cannot use cut shapes with an image. What we can do is we can use these squares as a mask. Now in looking at this, I see that if I broke this into 4 sections that were 3 by 2, that should work pretty well. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my master image. I'm going to right click on it and say duplicate. I'm going to put that on the blue layer. I'm going to duplicate again, put it on the red layer, duplicate a fourth time, or a third time, I guess, to have 4 total images, have that on the green layer. Let's just move this down to the bottom so we can see it. Okay. I'm going to hide 3 of those images so we can just deal with 1 at a time. I'm also going to take my templates essentially and grab 6 of them at a time, group them together. That way I can use all 6 of those as one object as my mask for the image. Turn the first image back on. Now by selecting this image and holding the shift key and selecting my first grid of 6 tiles, I can right click and choose this option that says apply mask to image. And you see how the image disappears except for what's in this masked area. That's exactly what we want. I right click again and I'm going to say flatten image. That's going to actually trim the image up so that I have one object that's no longer masked. I can move it around and do whatever I want. I'm going to do that same process now with each one of these layers and each one of my masking areas. I'm going to choose this upper one, right click, apply the mask, right click again, flatten image. Go to the red layer, do the same thing. Pick the image, shift, select my mask, right click, apply the mask, and then flatten the image. One more, pick the image, shift, select the mask, right click, apply image, and flatten. Now if we turn all of these on, it looks like one picture, but we can see that each one of these is its own little chunk. And for the cutting process, I'll just throw each one of these into that lower left-hand corner. And then this is an area that I can burn. It's all within my burning area. And to do the burn, I just turn three of them off, and I can burn this 2x6 section, and then turn that off. Then I can burn the next section. Turn that off, the next one on, burn that section. And the same for this last one. So that's how this process works. It's pretty slick. It, again, kind of putzy, but you run into that when you you know, have the desire to cut something bigger than your burn area. You have to deal with that, especially if you're working with tiles. If you had a pass-through and a large chunk of plywood, there's other methods for doing that. Here we have small tiles with a big image, and we want to break the image up into areas that we can print at one time. I hope you found this useful. Please give this a thumbs up. I hope you enjoy doing your CNC at home projects. Oops.